Welcome back. It's been a while since I played Go, hasn't it? Apparently, for the last month or so, I've been living under a rock and did not notice that this game now has online support, not just for their own game server, but for the online Go game server. So in the few minutes before this stream, I set up this game with my online Go account. And so now, or my OGS account, the online Go server. And so now I should be able to play against opponents on that server. So let's give this a shot. Hello, good luck, have fun. Am I first? I'm first. Okay. Cool. Man, this looks beautiful already, and I'm sure it has potential only to get more beautiful. Let's see. I'm going to play a little bit strangely here. I'm not exactly sure where I want to put everything, so I'm playing, I guess, a little too solidly. Basically, I just want to be careful not to overextend myself like I want to do. This is going to be a nice little warm-up game. And then maybe we'll jump right into the 19x19 again. Okay. So these are effectively connected here. I could place a stone here to cut, essentially. So let's do that. And so now if he just completely ignores it, I just cut here. And his problems only grow. Or I cut there. That's probably an even better cut. They do say Tahani at the head of two stones, but I'm not sure if that entirely applies to this situation. If I go there, I'm dying-ish, so... yeah, let's just build up some thickness here and take the top half of the board. Now, don't I get this for free? I think this is free. So let's take it. So that's Atari. He has to protect here, or I guess he could sack the stone. But this is a pretty vital cutting point between two stones now, so... Yeah, he's just going to defend that. And I'll just keep extending. Right. So as long as I don't get Atari'd, I should be just fine. And I've got 4 ranks on the top half to his 3 ranks on the bottom. So I should be doing okay. I guess I have placed a couple stones in my own territory, so maybe I should have played more aggressively this game. Although, I mean, I can reduce him too. At the moment I'm threatening this. So yes, of course he plays it. Am I still ahead if I do this? Well, am I ahead? I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna still threaten to try to Atari some of this down here and still try to reduce the corner. But my evaluation's shifting to I'm thinking he's better. I've played just too solidly this game. Yeah, so he has another Hane there. Okay, well, I'll extend down here. It's possible I might not be doing very well here. Because if I count this as three ranks for me and three ranks for him, I've probably miscounted. I assume he just plays here and I'm screwed, right? Is that greedy? I mean, he's well within his rights to play there. Okay. We'll see just how this goes. I might be starting to almost live down here. Either way, my opening play is looking pretty cowardly. Okay, that's Atari. I do need to protect. I think I'm getting rolled this game pretty badly. Like, he just goes there. I've given up too much. Although I am starting to get something down here, so maybe it's not a total wash. But yeah, this is anything but, well, it shows that I've got like an empty triangle here and one there, one here. So I've pretty clearly misplayed something. If he does play there, I guess I play here, forcing this, and then I start expanding down here. Or maybe I don't bother doing that in that order. But I don't want to let him keep expanding just continuously. Okay. This makes another cut point for, but I want to try to claim something. I want to do my best to try to reduce this down here, even though a single stone by itself isn't going to get very far, is it? I think he plays here, and my problems are evident. I think if he plays here, I do have to let the stone go. And then I just connect here. build up some thickness, try to take some space in this corner, but it's pretty pathetic. I don't think I want to double down and try, well, I don't know. Like, if I let him take my stone, I don't have enough room to live down here. This is a useful stone that separates his stones, so I want to keep it. Plus, this allows me to extend into the corner and grab a little space there. So now he's got this corner, the lower left. I've got the upper right corner, and part of the right edge. He's got a stone. I'm going to start going after his guys here. Even though this isn't going to kill anything, I don't think. Maybe H2 down here would have been a better try. I wonder if I can get coordinates. And I mean, it detracts from the beauty of this whole thing. But without coordinates, it's difficult for viewers to commentate on what's going on. In person, it's different because they can use nouns to describe. This is a Hane type of play. This is a whatever it is sort of play. But online, all you've got is just the coordinates. Okay, so if I play up here, he protects. Oh, yeah, this is self-Atari, by the way. He protects and Ataris me. If I play here, that's two steps away from Atari, which is not nearly good enough. If I play here, he goes there, I connect, the Ataris, I'm dead. If I go here, threatening to try to Atari, and I've played pretty solidly. If he Ataris, I go here, Ataris again. I'm dead again. Your opponent has not responded. Do you want to abandon the game? Well, I mean, it's my move. There's no reason for me to abandon a game, when it's my turn. The reason he's not responding is because it's my move. So yeah, if he plays there, I Atari. Now if he... Oh. I could have seen that coming. Now I have to protect. Or he can successfully Atari me. Alright, so we protect the cut. So he's got three territory over here. If I threaten to kill, yeah, so he's going to protect that further. He's almost got two eyes. He'd have to royally mess up to not get two eyes. So meanwhile, I'm going to play over here. He's going to kill. I'm going to do what I can to get something out of this. Oh, Well, yeah, this is Atari, by the way, so. Right. Okay, and the wall's complete. So now to count things up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 13, 17, 18, 19 versus my 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, whatever. I have to learn to count this better. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 24. So I'm not interested in playing in my own territory. I don't have a good chance of living, although it doesn't risk anything to try something, but against basically any sensible play, I don't have anything special here. White wins by 2.5. So I failed to cover Comey. Can I say good game or something? So he did capture one of my stones, right? He gets a 7.5 advantage for going second, or have 7.5 points for playing second. And I failed to cover that spread. So white wins by 2.5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Did I count that right last time? 3, 7, 11, 12, 14, 17, 20. Yeah, he has 20 spaces. I have 6, 11, 13, 15, 19, 24. So my 24 minus is 20, and then we count 7.5 there, and the captured stone. So how is it that he wins by 2.5 instead of 4.5? I'm confused. I think either way he wins is the point. But I am most confused by this scoring. It says both of us have zero territory, so it's not counting the territory difference. I don't understand how it came up with that score. Let me check this on Online Go. I'm curious how, if at all, this is scored there. How do they score this game? So, let's get over there. OnlineGo.com. Okay, so this site. Yeah, site says that white wins by 2.5. Alright, how does this scored on the site? I mean, obviously. I just don't understand it. I mean, certainly this is beautiful in terms of the client. But, oh, I'm sorry, I just mouse over the players. I see I have 24 territory. My opponent has 20 territory and 5.5 Komi. So Komi's not 7.5, Komi's 5.5 for this board size. Yeah, you did capture a prisoner. So, yeah, I had 4 more territory than he had. And, yeah, that was cool. Interesting. At least the correct score made its way through, even if the scoring itself differed a bit. So let's go back to the main menu. Let's play another game. Here, let's try a game. Let's try a game with Mr. Todd. Good luck, Mr. Todd. May the force be with you. You know, I should get in the habit of playing Tengen more often if I'm playing on this miniature board. This is a huge jump and a skip, but there's some sense to it. All right, so there's a couple cutting points here. Yeah, let's pick one. Pick a fight right off the bat. And okay, he's could cut me in either place, but I just protected the other one. But yeah, why don't we just peek like this? Is this called peeking? I'm learning a bit about Go terminology. Okay. Sure. I'm willing to build a wall if you are. Oh wait, now you can just play there to threaten to cut and I have to protect. Still, I got a heck of a lot of influence here, do I not? I mean, look, I've got, okay. How much territory do I have to take to win this? Am I gonna capture this stone? I don't have enough influence to capture it outright. Well, not without consequences. Interesting. What do I do here? Yeah, let's just protect the corner. Now he could jump way over here. I guess I haven't done anything about this corner, but I think I'm pretty good overall. Maybe this is too defensive. Yeah, he just plays here. I failed to prove anything. Well, if he plays there, I Atari. I do get the stone. He could Atari me back and we could have all kinds of fun fighting going on. Why don't I just play this? Seems like an obvious Atari. Okay. Now I know they say empty triangles are bad, but I'm threatening to build a wall in numerous ways here, or on a small enough board that I think this is okay. Am I getting killed somehow? I don't think so. He'd need to just keep extending. This is not self-Atari. So I get to kill three stones. Spiffy. I guess no, that does Atari my stone here. Forces me to build upward, but I think I'm killing these. I think he's just far too spread out. Maybe this was unnecessary, but it sure looked necessary to me. I could have spent more time looking at alternatives. So he plays here. It's a step away from doing Atari of these three. Do I just protect these stones, or do I? No, this does nothing. This is absolutely nothing. It makes more sense for me to protect. Although he can't play there. He could play here and try to surround me. It doesn't gain me anything to play here. Other than a sense that I'm doing something. Where do I go? Is it imperative that I kill these just so I can connect everything up? Do I cut here? Even though really that just costs me a move. Here, let's solidify this. Guaranteeing myself everything in that corner. So sure, he cut into my territory, but it's not serving him well. Iffy Ataris I kill, because this is Atari. But more importantly, this protects my weak stone, takes the corner, threatens to do fun stuff over here. Right, so that's reasonable. So what do I do about these stones? Can I kill them? I don't want to get trapped here. Well, I'm not trapped because I'm just killing these three, but I want to have more influence than I have. I go there. This picks a fight where I don't have very much influence. It'd be better to fight up here. But what am I fighting for? So if I go here, he's gonna connect underneath. I can fight here. This seems like a good cutting point. Man, I don't like building triangles, but I don't see anything better. So that's Atari, so I have to kill those three. Now where do I cut? Do I cut there? Do I try to do something else? If I go here, he can Atari. Likewise, here he could Atari me. I extend Ataris again. Do I think these are alive at all? I really don't. There's no hurry to kill those. Here, yeah, let's extend down here. He's got to do something to protect, otherwise I'm going to maybe do something over here, I'm not sure. Either way, this is a reduction that threatens to reduce further. Yeah, apparently in December, this game linked up to the online Go server. And I just today found out about it, so pretty excited about that, even though we have no coordinates here. Coordinates would be pretty nice. I haven't counted territory. I really should be doing that throughout the game. Been more focusing on not making terrible blunders. Now, can I go there? No, that's overextending way too much. I can keep going this way, though. Just filling in Dame, in a sense. Although, I mean, if I go here, he cuts me. In fact, that's Atari right there. If I go here, he connects. So yeah, let's just keep pushing on by. Let's see how much I can reduce this. Right, it's not exactly Dame. Yeah. Alright, so the question is, can I kill this? The answer is almost certainly yes. The next question is how. I mean, this is surely not at all, in any sense of the word, alive. So it must be possible to kill it. Right, the only tricky part is that I've got 1 minute and 5 Byoyomi. So, we gotta buckle down and get this done. I go here, he goes there. I'm gonna go here. Just start poking out eyes. Or potential eye space. Ah, shit. He's taking a stone. If he plays there, I guess it doesn't matter. That doesn't help him live at all. I panicked due to that. Ticking of the timer. I forgot like how Byo-Yomi works. I've actually got 5 Byo-Yomi here, so the timer's not a problem. But yeah, that timer noise is definitely designed to get your attention. Wait, can I keep just, like, repeatedly throwing in on this cut point? He lived. Well, damn. That's no good. I mean, we're double-digit Qs, so maybe I'll find some way to weasel out of it. I still don't understand this stuff. I've solved one of these life-or-death problems, I've solved 100 of these, but I still never understand it. Self-Atari either way. These are self-Atari, but they make life difficult for him. Oh, shit. Okay, so I have to do this. But it doesn't work. And I have to try this. But this doesn't work either. So there's my Atari, but it's no good. Yeah, and he lives. So, barring some miracle, I have completely effed this up. I did capture some stones earlier this game, but it's not going to nearly be enough to cover that spread. So, just out of frustration, really, I'm just playing a few more stones. Oh, that's no good. He just connects. Yeah. I can pass. There's nothing more for me here. White wins by 10.5. Good game, good game. What the hell? Go's difficult. Playing on a 9x9 board is tricky. How do I kill this? I played this greedy way here. Maybe I didn't need to go grab this one extra territory down there. Maybe it would have been better to try to do something about this situation. Okay, in this situation, what's the score? Now, I did discover earlier that that's not actually 10.5, it's 8.5 because Comey here is incorrect. Like here, I don't know, I could play stuff. It could be okay. Like here, just play this and see how he reacts to it. I'm not sure how we can manage to do better than that. Then only once I've stopped him from living here, then do something. All right, well, I'm sure more games will teach us things. Let's create a new 19 by 19 game. Main time per side, 150 seconds. 3Boyomi at 30. 150. Where did it come up with that number, I wonder? I mean, I guess we could try it. That's like 2.5 minutes. Let's try that. 10 minutes. Ranked. Yeah, we'll say unranked. I don't know. Yeah, we've got an audience here. We'll play an unranked game. That's cool that you could challenge Steam friends here, too. But yeah, they're saying while we're still in beta, it's probably best to just play unranked games. When they've tested this enough and feel that it's time to take it out of beta, then that might be a better, okay. Well, I guess let's do this. I'm curious why this isn't done so often. Like, I think this is a thing. This might be an old way of playing. He takes the corner. That seems like a really low move. Okay, can I? What would be a reasonable space to try to invade? Here, let's prevent this from becoming anything. Black wins. Cool. Seems like a fun way to play. I don't know Joseki. So this is, anything I do is going to be fun. Sure, why not? Oh, I was hoping like with these eyes up here, we get a nice little mouth shape and we have like a smiley face. My opponent does not like the smiley face opening. Bummer. Okay, this is an interesting local situation. Oh, I can actually zoom in on the board. Let's do that. That looks better. So what now? They say build a base. That's what they say. I could just place something out here somewhere. That looks kind of sort of maybe like a base, perhaps. Okay. You can have that corner, I guess. Oh, welcome back. Everyone stream and go now. Well, good to know that I'm everyone. You attach to the start point stone. I will have to understand that one day. Alright, we'll fight. Fighting's fun. I'm gonna assume that he knows this Joseki. And that he's alive here, but now, how do I extract something out of this? Or do I just let it be? If I just ignore it, he just cuts me. But, I mean, do I care? I don't know. We'll fight in the corner. We're going to learn things by fighting. Learn things like give peace a chance. Alright, so we built up all the thickness in the world. 1, 2, 3, jump. 1, 2, 3, there's the jump. So, if I just build something up over here, I've got a little bit of space on the side. He's taking the corner. I'm unhappy about that. What do I take? Maybe this is too slow? I'm not sure. I really don't understand that move. Well, he's trying to reduce my influence in that area, I guess. I don't know. I don't exactly want to pick a fight with it. Maybe I do. If I do, he gets some center influence and whatever, but, okay, well, I will do something here. Can I? What can I do? I mean, I keep running and running, but he keeps trying to do clever things. Okay, I'm just gonna cut him. I've got way more influence in this local space than he has. So this has gotta somehow be a positive thing. He's gonna have to spend some time not getting killed. Trying to surround my dudes here, but I'm not sure why he bothers. Well, I guess, yeah, he wants this whole entire bottom section of the board. I can't just let my two stones go for nothing. So we'll run. Sir, what is this? What is this madness? Is he like calculating ladders and stuff? Do I do this first? And he extends, it's almost Atari, and then I try to do stuff? Or do I just go for a net right here? White passed. I don't know if that's intentional or not. Yeah, that was the most confusing thing ever. I'm pretty sure that was just an accident on his part. So what's he doing? Seriously, what is this? See how many stones we can place on the board? He's not even threatening anything. Like here, at least I'm protecting things. He's just plunking stones on here. I don't get it. We're both ignoring larger areas of the board anyway. Do I cross cut? I'm going into that fight at down a tempo, but I don't know. I think I'm doing okay. Okay, this stone's alive. We're gonna have to find some creative way to run here. That was a lot of stones that didn't do very much. Yeah, he's greedy. Look at all those greedy moves. That's crazy. Man loves his stones. And apparently enjoys playing as quickly as I play. I don't understand that. Why throw an extra stone in when it's gonna die anyway? I'm just gonna protect this so I don't do something stupid like last game. Okay, since that's Atari, I have to respond. Okay, he's building up something in the center by attacking these. Feels quite hokey to kill this one stone just to connect, but apparently that's what he wants me to do. So we connect. Am I winning a capture race here? If threats of captures are present. I'm not sure. I could have seen that if my timer weren't ticking furiously. So, okay, I blew my 3 stones there. It's not very wise of me to lose my 3 stones. But it's just 3. We can come back from that. I don't know, it's really easy to fixate on these little battles, when I have no time to think. I'm tending to play where he tends to play. I'm always just instinctively responding to it, pretending like he's doing something. Fuck. See, this is why I've been trying to respond to his things. Because I can't calculate for squat. So I'm being better safe than sorry, but wait. Still can't calculate this. It's not looking good. Yeah, see, that's. Yeah. I'm too ticked off to continue that game. It was a fun game. Let's play another game. See, that's why I'm responding, is because I can't calculate. We're gonna change the Byo-Yomi to 60. So I have some hope of being able to respond to some of these things. Alright. Yeah. I don't think this interface makes such things possible. Yeah, but I think most of the things you want to show me would be over my head anyway. I understand that I was playing lots of really small moves. And I mean, they say that you should just lose your first 100 or whatever games as quickly as possible and get beyond that point. Okay, it did take my move. I was wondering if I froze and hung or something. They are simple things. Oh. That's a pity. The other thing that's unfortunate about this interface, as beautiful as it is there's no coordinates, so when I'm streaming this, it's not so easy for people to commentate on what's going on. Okay, that is quite a large move here. We're gonna attempt to play Joseki. I don't know squat about Joseki, so this is probably a really bad move. But Here we are with 3-3 Joseki. Yeah, I actually did log on OGS just to check the COMI of the other game, figure out how that calculation was done. Well, oh, I keep getting confused by the fact that my timer is not ticking down when his is ticking down, even though the text is black. But that's just a stylistic choice of this interface. Okay. Yeah. Go's not easy, guys. I know I make chess look easy sometimes, because chess is easy. I kid. I kid very much. It's especially tricky knowing when to respond when your opponent is just blitzing out every freaking move and not giving you any respite whatsoever. He had 7 minutes left or something by the time I resigned. I very much get the sense that he was bored with my play. All right, so he cuts me, I cut him. I don't know if he places a stone there or not to deal with the Atari situation. I'm not even considering taking that right away. Well, now I am. So this must have been some kind of Joseki, maybe. Yeah, to resolve this local situation. Whoops, that's too far zoomed in again. Is this okay for people? Okay, I can't shift the board around. So, you know, let's zoom back out a touch. Okay. See, I don't even... I mean, yeah, he's threatening my stone cuts his stones, whatever. But there are larger plays on the board than to fight this co-fight back and forth. As long as him taking there doesn't end up in him killing me badly. Like, why don't I extend over here and try to get some influencer stuff? Playing one of these spaces seems really... I don't know. Fruitless? I could just play here, take this entire side, play here, I don't know, play over here somewhere. I don't want to walk into this, pincer. Yeah, why don't I just build up some influence down here? I also kind of miss the harp music. Man, some kind of sound effects would be pretty cool. Or at least somehow bringing the harp back into the game. It's cool that from the title screen and elsewhere I can get that, but... well, the rule of thumb is 1-2-3 jump, so we're going to place a third stone and not burn my entire clock. Although this time we're playing with 60-second Byo-Yomi, so I've got actual time to think if I need it. And I will. I mean, sure, he's building up a lot of center influence here, but I'm getting the corner and the side. I still don't know if this, what to do about this situation locally. But if he takes there, I could always connect either direction. Again, I'm not really tempted to walk into the pincer. I could just take more space out here somehow. Or something like this and try to extend into here, maybe. Or something way more aggressive like this. Seems a bit too much. Where do I go? Let's just protect the corner. So now we got a fourth line and a third line stone. Next, I can play fourth line pretty much anywhere out there. Now watch as I'm playing all this positional go. He's just gonna kill my stones in the corner and whatever. I could even play a third line move here. Let's try that. Well, look at him build up all that center influence, man. Yeah, let's just build a freaking wall of China over here. Okay. Of course, I'm gonna fight you for more space here. Maybe I could have fought more closely. Maybe try to cut him altogether would have been even wiser. It seems like an empty triangle, though. Here, let's just connect this way. So, if he connects there, that's an empty triangle. If he doesn't, I might cut him. Okay, this is a tari. Unless I'm missing something. Do I even care? Do I play this way to atari him? This seems unwise. Oh no, I have a wall right here. Let's just kill this. If he's trying to kill my stone, I'm gonna try to kill his stone. Yeah, he's playing for influence, but he's putting his stones pretty closely together to just get influence. I mean, it's pretty clear he doesn't care about this corner or this side of the board. Okay, I got the markers to go away. So he's got a connect here, and then this is basically Atari. Or does he connect underneath? Did I just completely miss something here? Atari? If he connects, I just kill. So what's this? I don't know, maybe you've been watching too much of this. Well, I'm not sure what he's going to do now. He might connect here, seeing that that's my threat. So he might threaten to connect, like connect here, threatening this, but either that or he might come up with a way to get more influence out here and just forget these guys. Because this situation seems pretty resolved to me. Also, you might try to do something tricky up here. There we go. There we go. Now we can pincer and fight and stuff. I've been told this is a pincer. I don't remember much else about it. So. Again, I've seen some Joseki before. I don't remember any of it. So, unless I feel like deriving it on the spot, we're gonna have to figure some things out. So he attaches to my stone. If I cut, he cross cuts. I don't know any of this. Literally do not know any of this. Maybe? Sure, this looks reasonable-ish. Yeah, I thought 3-3, like the corner play, was a response to the pincer. But that's all I remember, honestly. And I certainly don't know the Joseki to follow it up. I'd probably just throw some stones somewhere in this general vicinity and get laughed at for putting them in the wrong spaces. But even with some inaccuracies, putting some stones in this area would be reasonable. I don't know what's going on. Like, if I play here, he goes there. I cut. He's playing for a lot of influence. This seems like a really obvious cut, so I'm gonna try it. Let's see where we go. think we got an okay game out of this. Although I still don't at all understand what's going on in the upper right corner. But overall, this seems pretty cool. Okay. What do I do about this attachment? They say attaching to a weak stone strengthens it, but really, what do I do? I get some influence, that's what I do. And if he keeps attacking, I just keep getting more and more influence. That seems okay. Do I keep cutting and cutting and cutting over here? When does it stop? When does the bleeding stop? This seems like influence. Don't let him connect for nothing. Oh. Yeah, free connections should be discouraged or prevented. Even this connecting, I'm kind of worried about, but this isn't chess, so this kind of diagonal cut across the board, I mean, that would net him some space down here, but it's not something to be completely terrified of. On the other hand, if I take this, I might be able to connect across the bottom, so let's take this. We kind of resolve the corner, kind of resolve this corner. Let's go for the side. And it's a star point, so it can't be that bad. Literally do not understand any of what he's doing there. Yeah, this is a Kaya board, right? This, I mean, I'm kind of a noob at Go, but this looks very much like Kaya to me. Like if he tries to kill any of my stones, I just keep killing and killing and connecting and taking more space, and probably want to put something out here somewhere. Oh no. Kaya.gs. Well, I unfortunately missed out on that era. Which of these ways do I... Yeah, I just kill this. So this protects both of my stones. If he tries to do something clever, I kill this guy too. Yeah, one thing I've learned recently is that this diamond shape is actually connected. As are just two stones that are a diagonal space apart. They're considered connected because if the opponent plays one, you play the other, and they're still connected. It's only when you're losing both of those connection points, due to threats and stuff that these aren't considered connected. But that's not the case here. That is really slow. I mean, if Hane at two stones is good, then this kind of block has got to be even better, right? So he spent all this time building up influence toward the center, and look what I'm doing. This is called influence. This is not really influenced down here, but do I connect? If I connect, I don't know. I guess I'm gonna let him build up some more influence. Because I'm not sure how safe I am. So he's gonna place here, and I'm not sure at what point we stop building this wall over here. But the center just keeps getting smaller. Alright, we're in Byo-Yami. Okay, we'll place another one way out there. Just try to find a way to get into the center and reduce it because, well, meanwhile, also trying to claim as much of the side as we can. Okay, what do I do about this? Do I just blindly connect like I've been doing most of the time, or do I do something a little different? I'm gonna try something different. It's quite a jump, sir. Quite a jump. If you can jump, I can jump. What to do? What to do? Only on account of him building this enormous wall am I bothering to put a stone anywhere near the center. Just to help me support if I need it later. The stone doesn't seem to do anything, so. Also, this is kind of in this vicinity, so what's the worst that could happen? Do I want to do something about this tension? That's really tense down here, now that I look at it. We're fighting. Not sure why he's picking a fight over here, but this seems to be the place to fight. the heck? That seems extremely strange. Okay. Like, what's he doing? He does know that this can't possibly live, right? That I've. I don't understand that. I am confused. Even if I let that con well, I don't want to let that connect. All right, so we're going to connect up. Oh, I see. If he plays there, I have a choice to make. Well, I can't. Yeah. If he plays there, I have to save my stones. These several over here do live. These several die. So it's a wash. Although he has reduced my territory, so go him. Interesting. I want to say I miscalculated somewhere. Or what they say is misread. Well, now I've got to do something about this group. Let's just connect it up. Still alive. Oh, it's Atari. Did not see the Atari. Okay. A stone for a stone. Another Atari move. We'll protect that. Instead of just letting him kill me, like, you know, I've been a pretty nice guy just letting my opponents kill my stones, but I don't have to do that. I can actually kill things if I put my mind to it. He patches the hole. I think I have to connect underneath. Or at least it behooves me to do this. Whether I have to do that's another matter. Look at that incredible density. Just plunk all the stones in one section of the board. Oh, how fantastic it would be if I could make this enormous net just to surround that block. Oh, connecting was really slow, so that was unnecessary. I don't have to worry about these two getting killed. Good to know. Sorry. Take the corner. Yeah, this situation's still tense over here. I should do something about it. It's really easy to get fixated on the local stuff. How do I even take the corner? I'm such a noob. Yeah, saving two stones is nothing compared to taking a corner. Two stones plus maybe a space or two was not necessary. I've been so obsessed about, hey, look at all this stuff I can kill. And I'm sure with enough focus I could manage to kill it. But space is worth stuff too. Yeah. How far can I let this run before I have to seal it? Like, if I let him play there, he gets out. See, now I've initiated on multiple fronts at once. My attention's completely divided. Yeah, this is the thing I was focusing on, this, and, like, my stones may be getting killed and stuff, so. It's just a really tense situation. Placing it one closer could probably have simplified all this calculation enormously. But I'm going to do the Zug-like thing and do things the hard way. That's where the adventure lies, guys. Okay. So we just say no to this. This might even be unnecessary, but things do get more complicated if I ignore it. How does that help him? Seriously. Atari? Okay, yeah, you're right. I've got 60 seconds to think. I don't need to, like, blitz this out. Yeah, the key point is if he tries to connect, I just Atari him again. And if he tries to get out, I just kill the group. So. Oh, poor Hilbert. We are double-digit Qs. Please forgive us for our transgressions. Oh, he plays down here. Okay, that's Atari. I could just ignore these two stones, or I could try to save them, and he Ataris me again. I go out, he Ataris me a third time. Well, this is Atari, too. This forces a response from him, so I get this for free. Actually, better than free, I get a free stone with it. He's gonna play there or something. Oh, I get two free stones. Two for the price of one. Cool. Does he want to put any more stones into the pile? Oh, poor Hilbert. Maybe I should be playing rated games, although we're playing with an audience here, and the audience is kind of helping me out a little bit. Well, that's Atari, so okay, I respond. Okay, that's also Atari. Yeah, let's respond to it. There's no harm in that response. Maybe things could have been better if I did something else, but you know, this is just fine. Literally do not understand any of what Black's doing here. Unless I self-Atari myself, I'm doing fine. This is probably unnecessary, but I'm just concerned. What if he gets two eyes somehow? I'm winning by such an enormous margin. I can afford to place a stone here just to simplify my life. Okay. That is Atari. Sure, I'll connect up. Oh no, he got one of my stones, guys. It's definitely the end of the world right there. Now what should I be doing? Because he's clearly not getting a second eye. I mean, just so I don't forget, I'm gonna connect. And, like, not lose these two. Sorry, I'm just doing what will help me relax a little bit here. It's been a tense 50 some moves. I'm giving myself a breather for one move, just so I don't have to constantly worry about that stuff. All right, now let's find a good move, like taking the corner. We can always go back and do that. He's not escaping in any way. Okay, that corner is taken. Maybe I should have played the first line move. I don't know. Oh, these? Well, okay, yeah, that was a wasted move. Yeah. Well, part of what's driving my priorities at the moment. I mean, I think I'm completely winning this game, am I not? So, I mean, what? I've done six captures, he's done three. I've got this edge and this corner. I did see this coming a mile away, which is why I played there. Nobody's winning this yet. Okay. So, killing this little dragon thing here doesn't matter because space counts for quite a lot in Go. I should maybe take this upper left corner. Like place, I don't know, 2-4? Does the 2-4 help me get that corner? Do I already have that corner? I don't know. Bonus points if I manage to kill this thing, right? that's not happening. But I can, like, he built up this big old wall. If I manage to make him run down here somehow, then I'm doing well. I'm not sure if this cutting point would have been reasonable. This could have been, I don't know. It's still there. Okay, he's trying to seal in my thing. I've got to take that into consideration. Like, this is self-Atari. I've been paying very little attention. Oh, what a dum-dum. What a dum-dum I am. Oh, fuck. See? This is why I play cautiously rather than aggressively. If you guys don't mind, I might rage quit after this game, if that's okay. Go is hard. See, I saw this, and I thought this was killing. It's not. So, if it's okay with everybody, I just might rage quit after this. Yeah. Well, this is why I kept playing stones in this area. So, I'm losing a lot of stones. He's gaining a lot of territory. I don't know what to do. Might accidentally lose on time. That could be fun. Let's do this. So we lost all these stones. He's got a lot of space. Whatever. We'll try to come back from this. Yeah, right. No, I agree. So, have you ever played chess with beginners? And you know how beginners love to, like, move instantly. And then they make the wrong moves. And you tell them, no, go back, you played the wrong move. And then the next game, they make the wrong move again. And you tell them again, no, you did the wrong thing. You can do this 1,000 times. And it isn't until after they've played lots and lots of games that they start to appreciate that there's something more to the game. You can't just tell them how to play. They have to experience it in a bit. And like, yeah, no, I get that connecting that was completely mistaken. It was misguided. It's a terrible move. I'm a terrible Go player. I have no business playing moves like that. Perhaps no business playing Go whatsoever. I don't know. I mean, yeah, you're right that it's a bad move. But I'm gonna make some bad moves just for the sake of trying to keep a level head while I'm playing. Just to try to keep things as simple as possible, at least as far as I see them. Okay. Yeah. Drama could be fun, I guess. Like I was saying, is it okay if I rage quit after the game? Because that really adds to the drama of the whole situation. All right. Like, I don't even know why I did that. This does connect all my stones, so maybe I have a lesser chance of getting killed here. Not sure why he's allowing me to do that. It's just weird. We're double-digit queues, guys. Bad things are gonna happen. Oh, that's Atari. Well, even if I get laddered, I'm okay, I think. I'm not even getting laddered there. Not sure what I was so worried about. So I lost like 10 stones, we'll say. And 10 territory. He's got a lot of influence over here he's not doing anything with. He still hasn't taken the corner. I've still got the corner in the side. This corner's really small. If I fight really hard, maybe something might happen. It's still really annoying that this played out the way it did. But that's entirely my fault. Also, the other thing that helps players improve just at chess is if they take their time. Now, with Go, that would make these games take an eternity. Like, if I took all the time it was necessary for me to read things out, these games could last a lot longer. And the moves could be a lot better. I guess that's part of why I've been largely avoiding this 19 by 19 board, is like, I'm not sitting down to play a 6-hour game of Go. As much as that would help me a lot. It would certainly help me with reading and understanding just what's going on. This makes no sense to me. Okay, I'm going to connect. Yeah, I'm getting used to the fact that, like, Go is not as quickly decided as chess. Like, I raged over this quite a bit. I was really pissed about it, how it turned out. But even with that happening, the game's not over. I'm at the point where I appreciate that it's like two games of chess, maybe. That even if I completely flub this local situation, that doesn't decide the game. Now, I'm still pretty dissatisfied with my understanding of what's going on, but that's something different. Now that's a bold move. I'm fighting over the wrong thing here. I mean, maybe this helps me, but probably down here or somewhere would have been better if I want to play for space down here. I'm really strengthening his situation, as weird as that is. Even here would have been more reasonable. I'm still very much on tilt. I didn't think I would be coming back from that tilt situation at all. But I'm slowly getting back. Man, at least this isn't Shogi. If you've seen my Shogi streams, those are something special. Well, no, I guess trying to disconnect his stones has some merit to it, but it's entirely misguided with so much of the board unclaimed. I should play here soon. This is probably like a 10-point play in itself. Okay. That's Atari. I hope he doesn't seal in this group here. Another casualty like that would not be fun. Now this is already super strongly connected, so I guess that's why I'm trying to make something of having it there. Okay, I'm gonna just make sure he doesn't get into this corner somehow. Have I played Heart.Break? I have not. Okay, that's silly. Oh wait, no, he could actually connect here. So it's not entirely stupid. It's just really slow. Like, glacially slow is this move. Point and click with extreme programming elements. Huh. I have to look into that. Maybe. Well, I'm curious. Okay, that's strange too. Kaboom! So, I'm not taking that for the stone, I'm taking it because that cuts all his stones. I can basically change the code of everything in the game if you know how. And doing so is necessary for solving the puzzles. So, it's kind of like Pony Island. But without ponies. People are gonna ask, like, what is Pony Island? But yeah, it's silliness. It's what it is. Yeah, I'll have to get that. Okay, that's self Atari. So that's. Oh! Right. Okay. I'm being dumb. Well, if you want to know how to distract me, just talk about a coding thing. No, I'm just kidding. It's a game. We're playing games. It's fun! Go is fun. Maybe. Then what I played might have even been okay there. All right, another Atari. Another free guy. Again, I'm just doing this so I can connect my stuff up. I don't care about the stone, I just care about resolving the local tension. And that was a way to resolve it. Now we just build a net and get this thing. I wonder if he'll let me do that. We're gonna try, guys. We're gonna try for the mega cheapo. But also no, I'm just slowly building up a wall to counter this wall. Monkey jump hurts. Okay. So now he's starting to add more tension over here. I can always kill this, so I don't need to worry too much. Guys, we're building a wall right here. This reminds me of that one AlphaGo game, where AlphaGo just put all these random stones. Oh, maybe this wasn't AlphaGo. No, I'm sorry, this is the ear reddening game that I'm remembering. Where Nindon just... Okay, maybe Nindon's incorrect, but really strong player just places all these stones all over the board, and then connects them all together with this one incredibly difficult to predict, but beautiful, beautiful connecting move. It's almost self-Atari. Let's play here. So, I'm not sure if I've succeeded in this cheapo, but it's starting to look very real. Yeah, I guess, okay, so this isn't like a 1 hour game, this Heart.Break. This is more than a 1 hour game. This is something I would potentially want to do on a weekend day or night. Actually, before I do that, I should finish Human Resource Machine. Still in my backlog, guys, but we're going to get there. All right, we're on his final Byo-Yomi. How does that help him? What is that move? That's like glacially slow again. Maybe cutting was better. I should have read that out. This is actually pretty important. Because that turns this into a capture race. Maybe. I'm exhausted, though. Just physically. Oh, here. Wait, no, that doesn't get me out. One, two. One, two. Oh, but he's filling in his liberties. One, two, three. This looks okay. I'm not seeing it, guys. You'll have to forgive me. On the bright side, I do get something out of this, but it's not the kill we were looking for. It's a really fun situation for sure. See, why don't they have stuff like this in Sumego? Just positions about fighting. It doesn't have to be to live or to die or in Ko or any of that. White wins by an honorable timeout. Okay, well, that was special. Like I said, I'm physically exhausted. I'm still tense over this whole situation. Like there's five phases of anger, or five stages of grief, rather. There's denial, anger, denial, bargaining, anger, depression, and acceptance. So, denial would be, I think I got past the denial phase there pretty quickly. Like, once I saw that I was losing my group, that denial was over like instantaneously. Bargaining was the whole I want to rage quit, just let me give up this game, don't want to continue this particular game, can always play another instance of the game ago, and just put that behind me. So we had that going on for a few minutes there where I'm like, come on, can I just let the game be over? Then after that, I guess the bargaining turned into, well, maybe I could at least get something out of this game. Maybe I don't have to lose it. Maybe I could either learn something or somehow do something productive to make it a close game. So that was the bargain. Anger was just dealing with all the tension that happened there. Really trying to get past that loss that occurred with all those stones and try to put all that emotion into something positive. Just not let it sit there, but try to do something constructive with it. So you saw me play a whole bunch of angry-ish kind of moves where I'm just passive-aggressively trying to build stuff up. Saying, you know what, I'm just going to keep plunking stones on the board, keep trying to attack things. not really take a very level head at the situation. That's basically where I was most of that game, was in the third stage of grief. Stage four of grief is depression. Just dealing with, man, that was an exhausting game. And stage five would be accepting it and learning that we learned something from this game. And I'm not ready to do that because I'm tired. So, acceptance is hooking them with the flag. Yeah, I don't believe that, but I think acceptance would be coming back to this game, looking at what I did right and wrong, and learning to be a better Go player because of it. And I am not ready to do that. I apologize, but I am so not ready to look at this game. I mean, we could understand why, right? That, like, I've been playing this Go for a couple hours on stream here. Generally losing most of the games. Generally just misreading tons of things. Understanding that I am still a double-digit Q, I'm still a beginner at this. And I should be accepting the fact that I'll make mistakes, although because I play so much chess, I'm not very accustomed to not winning. And just overall, I'm a pretty sore loser. So with that out there, yeah, I just need to accept that, like, I'm not gonna become some Go genius overnight. That it is a long, hard path, just like chess is. Just like anything. Becoming good at anything involves work. I probably did cheese my opponent quite a bit. Cheese in terms of just pissing him off. I think in this final position, if I'm going to learn at least one thing from this, it's that playing either of these two points does not increase the liberty of these two stones. I think that's the case. Like, if I go back one, instead of playing what I did play, maybe this was interesting. No. I'm still getting surrounded here. So I guess this group can't be killed at this point. Did I have something earlier that might have worked? Oh, I filled in my own liberty. That's what I did. No, I didn't even fill it in. He filled that. But, like, if I played here, he just would have played there. We had a very similar situation. There's gotta be some way to seal this in, right? I still have three liberties at this point. It's only when I go down to two liberties that things get difficult for me. The Atari was correct. If he extends your Atari up. Wait, what? This Atari was correct. If he extends, you're talking about this Atari, right? This is Atari! Oh my god. Like, I saw this is Atari. He's threatening this stone, threatening these three stones, and I'm like, holy crap, it's all. The end is nigh. Let's give up, concede. It's terrible. Like, if I play here, I lose four stones. If I go there, he kills my three. Going, extending up here is Atari. Okay, maybe there's something here, but I'm probably doing fine. Oh, wait. Wait. Let's be patient. So I have to take that. I still think this could have been challenging, but that just kills two stones. I don't care about that. So what do I do about these guys now? I could Atari again, and then connect, and then these three don't die. Do I have a better way? I mean, I could like threaten to connect up here. So this threat, like, he could fill in his own liberty to try to kill me. Actually, he doesn't. I don't even need to do that. So say he does this and say how I'm somehow afraid of it, I guess. I don't know. Don't even know why. Yeah, this would take time and effort to read out. But at least this group down here is dead. Way to save the five stones is to kill the bow. Right, instead of doing something to escape out this way, just kill these guys. That'll escape. That escapes in a hurry. So, not sure if I can afford Tempe to do this. Just save these guys first. Wait, am I laddering myself? That looks suspiciously like a ladder. So maybe I. Wait, that's not a ladder. I'm still threatening stuff. And I'm not sure if saving the two stones is even worth it, but I could. I have to disconnect those stones. That being, those being this over here. Oh, right. Yeah. I have to do something over here, like this. If he does that, then I have to connect this, and I guess he's got stuff. I don't know how that evaluates. Probably easier to just do this. And if he does that, then I'm eventually just going to connect up this way. I'm an Atari. I can't do that. I have to do this. He is two steps away, sort of, not really. I mean, I could even do that if I needed to run, but I don't. So, backing up. Yeah, I'm just fine if I play this. Yeah, it's I'm not sealed in. Like if I just played some random waiting move, or if he had one more stone in the vicinity is the point I'm trying to get to. Like if he had something over here somewhere, this could be a lot more difficult. Maybe. Maybe not. But yeah, I just play here. This doesn't increase the number of liberties, but it does threaten to connect, and connecting would certainly increase my liberties. And so he could stop me from connecting by filling in his own liberty, but he doesn't want to do that because this group's dead. So, yeah, it's pretty easy to extend these five stones now, six, just give them more liberties. Even though this stone itself does not immediately grant more liberties than we immediately had right here. We had one, two, next to this three, but I mean, we count the stuff out here too. Because he can't play there. Yeah. Simple read. I mean, it should be simple. I've been doing this for at least 2 hours here. Like I said, I'm physically exhausted. Was up before sunrise, to use a euphemism. I do need to sleep at some point. But yeah. At least we learned to read out that little bit at the end. And learned, although we kind of already knew this, that one way to connect up your stones is just to kill all the stuff in the middle. I suppose the other thing that would have been worth learning, just at my double-digit queue level, would be when did that thing on the left actually become a threat? Like, okay, so I played this. Oh, I'm sorry, he played that. At this point, I have two liberties. I could just play this, and then if he tries to enclose me, I just kill his enclosing stuff. No. I'm too slow. Maybe this is the critical point. I tried to kill two stones and got my whole everything killed. This might have been the point at which he gets out. Left of town. Oh, right here? Seriously? Oh, that's his weakest stone. I had a decent motivation. You sure? I've got one liberty. I don't know. It's a double Atari. Where's the other Atari? Oh, okay. I was thinking about this though, right? And then this thing is kind of like Seki, they say, where neither one of us can play this point. But, I mean, obviously in the global context, I'm going to surround this and kill his stuff. Wait, I'm no closer than I was a turn ago. I'm still too slow. What am I thinking? Okay, so basically, this was just me being retarded. So we had that. This was the dumb move. This applies no pressure on any of his stones. Yes, I'm trying to enclose everything here. Maybe I could have gotten away with it. Maybe it's a decent move, but reading it, it just completely fails. That's much, 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 much too slow. Because he plays here. I didn't think this was a serious thing. But it actually is. The worst part about this is like, say if I just played it here. That would have made great sense. I'm actually threatening to connect here. And if he does this, I'm fine. But no, I just played this retardedly slow move that actually makes this move make some sense. Yeah. That makes sense. Easier said than done, but it makes sense. I didn't see that this group was short of liberties. Because like, there's a liberty, there's a liberty, there's a liberty. It's only after what actually happened in the game. What if I hit revert? Okay, that brings us to the end, from which I can go back and explore what actually happened to the game, which was me just playing the dumb move. After this, yeah, it's pretty bad. I protected my one stone here, though. So, there's that. But other than protecting my stone, that doesn't make any sense. Like, here would have been reasonable trying to extend out that way. Leftward would have been reasonable. Tengen would have been fine. Doing anything in any of the corners would have been good. But this move is just bad. Like, double digit Q bad. It was just wishful thinking that I'll just put a stone here, one there, one there, one there. And once I play all my stones and he doesn't do anything, I'm just winning. This is arrogant. Yeah, I guess that's the moral of the story. Oh, well, yeah. I'm using the word good very loosely. I'm using the word good to mean not completely, entirely, double-digit Q atrocious. I mean, yeah, I could lose all these stones, give them all the territory that's occupied by those stones. But at least I'd get something constructive if I played my stone anywhere else on the board. But playing it here doesn't do shit. Now, yeah, as you point out, that obviously I have to deal with this situation. This is medium size. There have been games where larger dragons have died. But that's not to say you just let your guys go like that. So, that was a game. I guess from that, I learned that, like, I guess even finding the word arrogant to describe this move, that might have been the learning step here. Just accepting that, even as a beginner, I'm showing some arrogance in this game. And part of that is just being exhausted, but part of that I just don't understand yet. Yeah. Oh, well, yeah, I guess I am killing the black group too, so we're not only going to count all my stones and all the territory he gets, but also the deficit of all the stones that I would have captured and all the territory I would have gotten, so that's like 4 times, what do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that's like a 40-point play to just drop this. Yeah, so it's pretty big. I mean, sure, if I just start placing some stones to take a corner, I get maybe 10 points out there. Maybe another 10 in another corner somewhere. But that only makes up for half of what we're losing here. Best case scenario. Probably doesn't even make that much. So yeah, this is actually pretty huge. So I was... Okay, so calling this thing here, calling it arrogant, might be inaccurate. Because, like, obviously it's terrible. But, considering that, you know, if I'd succeeded to kill his stuff, if I'd been paying the slightest bit of attention and actually calculated things correctly, and the problem there is, like, so I've been paying attention over here, did all this right, managed to not lose the corner, did that right, managed to, like, not die several times over here, and now we're, like, not quite 100 moves into the game. I can't even count at this point. I want to say 80 moves into the game, maybe 60. I have no sense of that. Does A10 not work? So I think you're talking about this point here, right? I was in a similar situation. I was thinking A10. I'm actually quite optimistic about A10. So he tries to enclose me like he did in the game. I kill this. And that's Atari. So that's still Atari, and yeah, A10 would have worked just fine. So that said, back here, A10 still pretty good. Not necessary, but I've always got it. But the way the game played, let's see, what was it? This. So once this is played, then A10 is kind of necessary. Or basically anything else that kills this group, but A10's a pretty good way to do it. Yeah. You note that, like, my analysis, some position afterward, after I played this dumb thing out here. Then I was looking for A10. A10 didn't quite cut it, but here it works just fine. Yeah. It's much larger than a Ko. A10 is the quickest way to kill this thing. Maybe not the cleanest, but it's definitely the quickest. This is fine too. Yeah, I mean, anything's fine here, but A10 is an interesting way to do it. I can always reserve that move for the end game, too. I don't have to play it right away. Now this is being lazy again. There might be other ways to do this. There's probably a cleanest way to kill this. Yeah, connecting's pretty easy. Even this loose connection's pretty easy. As for what's globally optimal here, I'm not sure which of the ways to kill that is the best. Yeah. Right, yeah, if I just connect here, the direct connection's obviously pretty strong. This indirect connection, I think this allows him later to like do something like that. Not necessarily here, but I'm playing with fire if I do this diagonal sort of thing. This would have been good. I actually like this one the most. The direct connection is really strong. This strengthens my stone here. I don't know, maybe plays like that. I'm too tired to keep reading stuff out. I'm sure most of what I'm doing here is just babbling. But yeah, what I wanted to do is like place some stones here and then somewhere over here, and it was gonna be beautiful. And then Go had other plans. Yeah. But anyway, yeah, what I did in the game was completely ridiculous. This is just wishful thinking. Completely ignoring the situation. I guess he has this here. And then I can still directly connect, but I mean, what am I doing? Yeah, so this just helps him get out faster. There's no reason to do that. And then that connects his stuff, and I don't want to do that. So, this is good. There might be better. Have I watched Battousai or Durin? I have not. Yeah, so far I've watched numerous lectures by Nick Sabicki. Watched is probably an incorrect term. Had them on casually in the background as I was coding stuff is probably a more accurate description. Because a lot of the stuff he does is pretty high level compared to what I'm doing. Yeah. I should probably watch Batosai then. Oh. In terms of watching things, and this has very little to do with Go, but yeah, I do have separate event planned for this coming weekend. Yeah, Nick seems like a cool dude. So the event this weekend is got invited by Lee Chess Master Atrophied, who we played a Crazy House and Blitz match with before. He's set up a match for us to play, and we're gonna play along with Snatch Pato and Chess Wiz. So we're gonna be playing some Bug House this weekend. So look forward to that. I think Saturday at 4 Eastern. That'll be good fun. I have not formally announced that, so. Yeah, might as well make the announcement here. And yeah, I think we're all on board to play then. So it might come as no surprise that in terms of who's partnered with who, I actually do not get atrophied for my partner. I know, this might come as a big surprise that one of Lee Chess's top 50 Crazy House players and a 2100 Crazy House player don't get to be on the same team. I know that's like the biggest shocker out there in the world. So yeah, no. For my partner, I get Chess Wiz. So that'll be good fun. You know what would actually make it more fun though? Is if we were playing against similarly rated opposition. I think that one of us is going to get rolled pretty hard by Atrophied. It'll be good fun, but yeah. I won't get to pull any of my Bug House antics. Yeah, Snatch is pretty cool. Snatch Pato. But man, you know. There are fun things you can do in Bug House. Like, your partner tells you, don't trade pieces without telling me or without asking me first. So sometimes in Bug House, I had situations where I just can't avoid a queen trade, or if it's can't avoid a knight trade, or can't avoid whatever piece trade. So one of the fun things you can do in Bug House is ask your partner if it's okay to trade pieces. And then immediately trade the pieces. And just say, oh, you didn't say anything. And there's just a whole bunch of fun, silly antics you can do in Bug House to, I don't know, make it more exciting. But we're actually going to be playing against Atrophied and Snatch Pato, so it's going to be a close and quite bloody match. I think probably what's going to happen is that I'm going to get paired up against Atrophied, or less likely, ChessWiz gets Atrophied, but I don't understand why. Because at that point, it just becomes a race for to see if I can checkmate Snatch before ChessWiz gets mated. Atrophied is actually really, really strong at Bug House. Like way up there with Jan Li and such. So plan is probably going to be one of us has to checkmate Snatch Pato really quickly, and the other of us just has to survive against Atrophied's crazy attacking ability. And considering that I can't checkmate for beans in Bug House, I should probably take Atrophied. But we'll see how things play out. It'll be a fun match. So yeah, stay tuned. That's this weekend, Saturday for Eastern. Hopefully everybody manages to make it online at that time and thing actually does happen. We'll be doing it live, so you'll have to pardon any technical difficulties should they occur. So yeah, that said, I learned some things this game. I'm still not fully accepting of, like, there's a whole bunch of other things I could learn about this game, like, what's this nonsense in the upper right corner? What's the Joseki? What should I know about any of this? Yeah, maybe we were 100 moves in. By the point that blunder occurred. Like, I don't understand any of this Joseki stuff. I did believe that this was ridiculous. This, oh, hey, look, he killed my stone. I don't know if I should have prevented that or not. I didn't feel like it was important. I still think it's a matter of taste what you do over here. But yeah, complete acceptance would be going through all these moves and seeing what are all the things I missed. What are all the things I can learn? And while that's a lot easier to do for a chess game, because chess games usually only go for 40 moves per player, Go games go for a lot of moves, so Go analyses take a while. So yeah, full acceptance would be just going through everything here and seeing, like, what could I have done better? Is there anything obvious I missed here? So I went for the corner. This is a new thing for me. I don't usually play the 3-3 point like that. Here he's just building up some thickness. Probably what I did was okay. And then he cuts me. This surely either is him just being greedy or this is Joseki, but this is why I didn't want to play the corner in the first place. I just thought it was a Joseki of some sort, so I did it. Okay, taking the stone's pretty pointless. Not entirely pointless, but pretty pointless. I don't know if I should have taken there. Like, I could just ignore that. I don't know, he does something. No, he's not gonna do that. I don't know. This is complicated. This probably would have made my life easier than killing the stone. I mean, yeah, okay, he can extend here. I don't know. Maybe killing it was right. Yeah. This seems like a fairly low-hanging piece of fruit to understand this particular situation. This is definitely better. Okay. Yeah, I guess I get this side of the board, so even if I lose two stones, what do I care? I mean, maybe I play this. I don't know. Maybe that's unnecessary. Yeah, in chess, I tend to play super aggressively. In Go, I'm gonna have to learn to balance things a little bit better. I descend and kill his black. Okay. I descend? Really? I guess so, yeah. This is like not even a contest, is it? Right. Okay. Is there anything complicating any of this? I guess lead off with that, but then I just kill this. I mean, I don't even necessarily know that I need to, but I've got that if I feel lazy. If I feel less lazy, I don't know what I do. Stuff is what I do. Yeah, so this connecting is definitely better. This move was, in retrospect, really weird. But it's the move he picked. I mean, it lets me connect, and I just refuse to do that. Yeah, at some point I'll have to learn how to play Go with a more level head, because Go is not chess. Go is not about constantly trying to attack stuff and kill stuff. Especially, like, playing chess on some servers, some players tend to play differently than on other servers. Not naming any names or anything, but I've played lots of blitz and bullet games where it's pretty clear that an opponent is not necessarily aiming to win by means of the board, but is trying to win on time. And it gets old pretty quickly. Oh, Black wanted his territory. Okay, so that's the point of this, is that, yeah, he gets the territory, but White gets some territory here too. I mean, okay, sure, you could try to reduce this a little bit. Not even sure how successful that effort's gonna be. I'm not sure what I would do against that. That seems pretty cool. Like, White's got two stones up here, two stones down there. Black just says, you know what? No. You don't get that. What do I do? I have nothing that is, like, anywhere near that stone. Approaching it is a mess. Joining to it just makes it stronger. I guess the point is that I go after the corners then, and just say, screw the side, and I'll take a corner somehow. Weird. I can attach to the 3-4 stone. We're talking about, so there's 4-4. This is 3-4, right? You're saying I can attach that. Oh, I'm sorry, the bottom. Okay, bottom 3-4. So there's 4-4, 3-4. I can attach to this. Here? 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 I don't know. Here? Maybe. One of these. 4-4. 3-5. 2-4. 3-3. On the fourth line, just push toward my strength. This here? Really? Oh, the left. I mean, I could play here if I have, like, no idea what I'm doing. Yeah. Five three is okay. So that's fine. This is okay. Actually, yeah, this kind of pushes him toward my wall there. 5-3 itself is okay. 3-3 looks ridiculous. Because he just connects here and my stone's doing nothing. Here at least something, something. I don't know. Okay, yeah, I guess the point is to seal in this group. So, like, say Black plays another move somewhere. Then we do a thing somehow, maybe. Maybe not. I don't know. 4, 8. Then we got somewhere like here. Or here somewhere. Yeah, it looks reasonable. I guess. Yeah, that way I'm not, like, too close to these stones. I'm still taking some territory. Oh. These two stones have M-I-A-I. I've always struggled pronouncing that word. Me-I, may-I. Probably me-I. I'm just drawing a blank on that. Other way, pushing the black strengthens the two. Yeah. Didn't want to get too close to this business here. So this looks reasonable. It does help connect all my stuff together. Yep, me-I. Okay. Cool. And then black says, no, I'm going to play out here somewhere randomly. Wait, what happened? Okay, I got my cursor back. And then white just plays go. I mean, then we Tengen. And then black plays the other star point. And no, I'm just messing at this point, but yeah. Right. There's always two ways to play something, at least. Yeah, it's just funny how black can throw these stones out there in the middle of nowhere, and it does reduce these local spaces, but it ignores the global situation. Like, if he plays here, that's forcing me away from this edge, but toward these corners inside. And this side's kind of already mine already, so I don't know. I have to play somewhere. Not sure where I would go. Man, I need to learn some of this corner stuff at some point, so I'm not completely adrift. Yeah, corners are bigger than the sides, but corners involve calculation. Oh my goodness. So much calculation. A side, you just put all the pieces, you form a nice little wall. It's really easy to count, really easy to see when things are in Atari. Corners, you get these kind of battles going on. You're like, what's going on here? But, huh. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I just like play here or something. Say, this is my corner. Isn't it beautiful? And black goes over there and we say, hey, look, I've still got my corner. And black makes this nice little cross. Probably playing there is pretty slow compared to other stuff you could do. Like this approaches this side as well as this corner and space over here. This is black just being silly. Though it's probably okay. Well, at least a double-digit Q level, this is probably fine. Sure confuses the heck out of me. Yeah, I'll have to see if I can find more games like this where black just takes all these star points and then white's like, I'll do something maybe. I'll just try to take every corner. Or three of them. Although here, like, taking that corner is a little tricky. So, like, enclosing the corner is just fine. That's almost never a blunder, to enclose stuff. And then, I don't know, enclose this corner, something, something. Although, this might be a bit too close there, but... like, I'm not sure I understand exactly how spaces get enclosed. I could play here, he could take this point. Seems weaker for me than the other way around. But, I don't know, is this really considered an enclosure? Does white have anything here? Does white step into a pincer? Go is tricky. I know I keep saying I'm wrapping this up, and at the same time I find this stuff, and I'm like, well, this is what would worry me during a game, because I don't know. Admittedly, this is no Joseki that, or nothing even resembling Joseki that I've ever seen. I've heard mention of this thing called Cosmic Go, which seems to be like you place your stones on the fourth and fifth lines, and stuff happens. Black approaches. Just add one more. Oh. Something that's threatening his approach stone. Like a direct threat of some sort? Like this? Do I have to... well, it doesn't have to attach to the stone, but okay, something that... just add one more move somewhere in that vicinity to... enclose. Like, here, maybe. I guess that's consistent, because, was it Gobaduk or somebody else the other day who was saying, you want to enclose stones, and you want to also make sure, like, any stone usually has three directions that it can run. And if two of the ways you can run have been taken away, you have to run the third way, or you just get enclosed. Just jump below your star point stone, or extend down. Oh. So it's fine to jump here. Or extend, if I wanted to. Depending on the situation, but okay. That's interesting. That seems a lot saner. You're not going to find that in any kind of... well, I don't know. Oh, I see, I see. So that's what I was missing. It's like, if I do this ridiculous thing, he jumps here, and we get Joseki stuff. So, right. Before we jump into the pincer, we first do this. And then if he does something silly, then we do that. Not that this is necessarily silly, but we have the ability to do something like this. And we're okay. We're not forcing him into the corner. We're forcing him toward the middle. Away from this corner. So, enclosing a corner is generally never bad. That's good to know. This particular kind of Joseki is good to know, where one player plays here, opponent plays there, you can just play right here. So this doesn't need to be like third line and fifth line and fourth line. You could do similar things on second and fourth and have some kind of support out here somewhere, and you're taking the side. We're trying to. But yeah, it makes sense that if he's approaching the corner, you want to say, no, you're not approaching the corner, and just re-enclose it. And if he doubles down and says, no, definitely, I'm approaching this, and you just add another stone somewhere. Say, no, I really don't think so. And if he just keeps going with this, just keep saying, no, I'm not letting you in. And if he does jump in, well, then you have to read stuff. But just play sensible moves in general. This jump is just ridiculous. This can't possibly work. You might even be able to ignore it, depending on the situation, I guess. I don't know. Watch Sabiki's video on the opening. Okay. He's done several videos on, like, the 4-4 point in the opening. The 4-3 point in the opening. But yeah, it requires I have the time. And to some extent, the ability to remember things without having played them. Like, Zug says that he doesn't remember anything just from hearing it. And he needs to be engaged in that. And I could learn just from listening. I am capable of that. But when I'm playing games and when I'm just enjoying leisure time, I find it more challenging to pick up that sort of thing than if I'm actually playing. Yes, I can learn from reading, I can learn from watching a video, but I have to be really seriously focused and committed for that to work. Otherwise, it's a lot easier for me to try to play. The general flow of the opening. Okay, that might be fun. Oh, cool. Yeah, I'll check that out. I don't promise that I'm going to remember anything from it, but it'll be fun. So. Right. Cool. Well, I'm still, with this particular game, I'm still not feeling like reviewing the entire game, but we did learn a number of things out of it. We had some fun misadventures here at the end where I'm just asking, well, like, what if Black does all these silly moves that I would do just to fluster my opponent? And there are some pretty straightforward answers. Corners are meant to be enclosed. And I know once he gave this lecture about, Nick Sabiki gave a lecture explaining to surround a space in the center of the board requires 1, 2, 3, 4 stones. On the edge, it's 1, 2, 3. And in the corner, it's just 1, 2 to surround a space. And so that's why players tend to surround the corners. They're really easy to surround and claim large gobs of space. It's much harder to do that in the center of the board. So that's the motivation for taking the corners. It's not because corners are anything like Othello or Reversi, where if you take a corner, then you can flip over your opponent's guys. Now, that doesn't work and go, but yeah, claiming corner space is a lot easier to claim than side or center space. I've actually wondered, what would happen if you had a Go board where all the dots were like, you see all these are right angles here? What if each of these were a 60-degree angle instead of a 90-degree angle? So you had, like, hexagons or triangles, equilateral triangles. How would that play differently than a standard Go board? You could have a spherical Go board, too. Oh, man, that would be challenging. A sphere or a torus. Yeah, and I was going toward hexagonal Go. I wonder how that would be different. And how other 2D geometries that don't wrap the board, I wonder how those would play out. Each stone... So... Well, no, am I misimagining something, I guess? Like, if everything were... So let's take Tengen. If everything were 60 degrees apart, you would have 6 points that were right away from the Tengen point. But no, I think what you're saying might also be valid, that you could have everything be 120 degrees apart and have a really interestingly shaped go board. But yeah, I think these alternate geometries would teach beginners a thing or two about go. Because I think this particular is rectilinear the right word? Orthogonal is probably a better word. But using this square board, or even a rectangular board, it's pretty complicated because having four neighbors is tricky. Probably having six neighbors would be even trickier, but having three would be really interesting. Yeah, I think your 120 degree idea is probably a lot better for beginners. That they could really appreciate a go board when, or appreciate what's going on when each, it's not a hex, but each intersection, each playable intersection would have only three neighbors. I think that'd be a lot easier for children to figure out than this standard go board. Tactics would all be different because, like, as you move to approach, you'd no longer have three directions that a stone could run, but probably only two. So yeah, like you're saying, it'd probably get really tactical. I'm curious how that would be, but I could always look into that. That could be fun. Either way, we've been doing this for quite a while. It's been a good, productive session. At some point, I do want to get back to my game of Human Resource Machine. Get to solving some of the more challenging puzzles. I think I've made it up to puzzle 30 or something. Still haven't hit very many difficult problems in a programming sense, though. If you've ever seen any of those videos, you'll know that I'm playing the game in the German language setting just because programming puzzles are pretty easy. So yeah, gotta get back to Human Resource Machine at some point, see if it can provide any challenge for me at all, other than trying to optimize the solutions, which understandably could be challenging. And then after that, yeah, so later this weekend we will have the bug house thing going on. I do want to eventually do the Advent of Code challenge. I understand that we're already into February, so we've missed Advent by like a month at least. But that could be a fun thing to do. Have I played Manufacturia? I've not. Yeah, Zachtronics is pretty cool, so it'd be good to check them out at some point too. But anyway, that's kind of what's ahead on the agenda. So, that'll be good fun. So for those who enjoyed the go, yeah, thanks for watching. It's been an interesting session here. Kind of surprised if people have stuck by for the go here, but you know, eventually it will improve. Or it'll be as awful as this the whole time. And we'll still have fun with it somehow. But at least I'll learn not to like hang 10 stone groups, giving up 10 territory at a time when I was threatening to do the opposite thing. Or at least when I do hang it, I'll make sure to do it under a more reasonable circumstance. One day. Someday. We'll eventually get there, I hope. Anyhow, yeah, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Look forward to seeing everybody for Chess and Bug House. I guess for Bug House this weekend. Yeah. And I'll see you next time. Take care.